everyone. I'm Catherine Price with the Cumberland River Compact, and today we're going to be talking about biodiversity. In Tennessee, we're really lucky to have amazing biodiversity all around us. So what is biodiversity anyways? Biodiversity simply refers to the variety of living things. And we can think about biodiversity at a population, ecosystem, regional, or even global level. And biodiversity is one of the things that makes living here on Earth so awe-inspiring with all the amazing things we share a home with. Today, we're gonna be focusing on biodiversity at the ecosystem and regional level. So let's go ahead and get started.
Biodiversity gives us the fascinating array of organisms that populate our Earth. But beyond the cool factor, why does it matter? Biodiversity is important for a number of reasons. First, healthy ecosystems require a variety of species to play different roles to support clean water, clean air, and other ecosystem services. When we lose biodiversity, an ecosystem is less productive at providing these services. Biodiverse systems tend to be more stable and resilient to change. As the number of species present increases, so does the probability that one or more of the species has the traits necessary to adapt to climatic change or environmental disturbance. This is increasingly important in the time of climate change where extreme climatic events are common. On top of that, scientists don't always have a full picture of how every ecosystem functions and how different species interact with each other. It's like a house of cards. Some cards can be removed without problems, but others, when removed, will cause the whole structure to collapse. Because we don't know exactly how this works, it is important to protect biodiversity as a whole. Biodiversity is also important to humans for a few reasons. One reason is the potential pharmaceutical value of living organisms. Almost 40% of prescription drugs that are sold around the world contain compounds found in nature. When species go extinct or disappear from an ecosystem, we lose their potential contribution to medicine. Furthermore, there is cultural value to biodiversity. The specific biodiversity of a location helps to create a sense of place and home for the people who live there. There is even some evidence to suggest that there are mental health benefits to biodiversity, and that the loss of species can be linked to increases in depression and decreases in overall well-being.
So as you can see, there's a lot of reasons to protect biodiversity. And in Tennessee, we're actually the 13th most biodiverse state when you consider plant and animal species. And for inland states, we're the most biodiverse. So we are very lucky. In Tennessee, our most biodiverse river is the Duck River. But across the whole state, we have a lot of different species. We have about 325 species of fish, 89 mammals, 61 reptiles, 70 amphibians, and over 340 species of birds that either live or migrate through Tennessee. So let's take a look at some of the species that live in Tennessee. So you might be wondering, why is Tennessee so biodiverse? Well, there's a few different reasons. First, Tennessee is a very long state. So the political boundaries of the state happen to encompass a lot of different ecosystems across the entire state. The second reason is because of Tennessee's location. During the last ice age, this area was not covered by glaciers. So animals that might have lived further north were pushed by those glaciers down into this region. So when they were living in this region around Tennessee and around Appalachia, there was a lot more competition and predation within those ecosystems, causing more evolution and more adaptations to come about from those individual animals. Like I said earlier, Tennessee has a lot of different ecosystems, and those allow for a lot of different biodiversity. There are small streams that are important habitat for different aquatic animals. We have mountain ranges, and across those mountain ranges, the ecosystems mirror what happens a lot across latitude. So we're able to have a wider biodiversity of animals within that elevational gradient. And also, Tennessee is a huge migration corridor for a lot of animals. Animals migrate through Tennessee, including things like purple martins and monarch butterflies, and that adds to the biodiversity that we see seasonally across the state.
We are lucky to have so many amazing species in Tennessee, but there are threats to biodiversity that are important to know about. These threats include habitat loss and fragmentation, land use changes and urbanization, pollution, invasive species, and climate change. With all of this amazing biodiversity in Tennessee, here are some ways you can learn more and get involved. You can make observations of biodiversity around you through the app iNaturalist. Simply upload observations of biodiversity you find and help scientists and the community track species distributions around the world. It's also a lot of fun, allowing you to identify different species of plants, animals, insects, and fungi with just a picture and location on your phone. You can also work with your local environmental organization to become an advocate for land and water protection so that all these species have habitats where they can live. For a more hands-on project, try planting a garden of native plants or planting a tree in your community.
So those are just some of the many ways that you can get out and enjoy and protect Tennessee's biodiversity. If you want to learn more, you can see some of the links in the description box below or visit our website at CumberlandRiverCompact.org. We hope to see you guys again soon. Take care.